My dream is to have that we have better models for volcanoes so we can better forecast what they will do in the future.
It was my lifelong dream to drill into a magma body, and I thought it would never happen. But then I found out these guys had done it and walked away from it.
Sometimes I find myself a little embarrassed how little we know about the exact details of volcano interiors. After all this research, after all these decades of very extensive research in volcanic regions, I would say there are very few, if any, volcano on Earth where we know in very good detail how much magma is inside a volcano at present.
Don't believe the cartoons in the textbooks. They're just cartoons. And a lot of the surprises during my career have been that ideas were wrong.
It's one of the lessons learned from ITTP1 is that our models of magma bodies inside the crust, inside volcanoes, they are simple, there's a lot of uncertainty, and they may be wrong.
And they were trying to avoid magma, which shows how much we have to learn about using geophysics to locate magma bodies, because this was a explicit attempt to not hit magma, and they did.
That really brings us to the Krabla magma testbed, where we want to learn more about how we can map magma inside volcanoes at the same time as we study the geothermal aspect. In the Krabla magma testbed, or KMT, we have the goal to improve our understanding of volcano interiors.
A testbed where people, different teams can come in over a period of time. And we can actually watch how this magma body evolves in time. There are big questions here that we can answer, that where we should see changes even on a few year time frame. We could actually put sensors in a magma body. You know, people now run around at the surface and they see seismicity and inflation, and they hypothesize what's going on. Well, nobody's ever tested this stuff. So if you actually could measure the pressure in a magma body and relate it to the deformation you're seeing on the surface, that would be a gigantic step forward. Early on in the process, the reaction was that I was crazy. But then I pointed out that people had done it accidentally a number of times without any real problems. And that if it can be done by accident, it can certainly be done by careful planning. And we can actually approach it scientifically and measure the things we want to know.
I'm very excited about maybe the topic you mentioned, science. I think volcano science is really important, and the way we monitor them, putting sensors close to the magma or even inside magma bodies is very interesting and appealing. And I think that may bring us to a new step in monitoring conditions of magma bodies around the world. So we'll use it as a laboratory. When we look ahead, decades ahead, maybe we will have sensors in magma bodies at many of the most dangerous volcanoes in the world. It would completely change our understanding of volcanoes.
There are wild dreams about, actually dropping sonde probes into the magma body to find out how deep it is and what the convection rates are there. All kinds of things you can imagine. But the very first is to get there and to build the hole so that it can last. We know where it is. We know that it's not going to come up and bite us. So that's all. We're just retracing the steps that were done accidentally, but this time prepared for it.